स्टार्ट एज पर द फैक्ट्स ऑफ द केस इन ब्रीफ द रिस्पोंडेंट प्लेंटिफ फाइल्ड ए सूट फॉर कैंसलेशन ऑफ द सेल डीड प्रेजेंटेड फॉर रजिस्ट्रेशन ऑन 13/10/1981 एंड रजिस्टर्ड इन द ऑफिस ऑफ सब रजिस्ट्रार एलेज्ड टू हैव बीन एग्जीक्यूटेड इन फेवर ऑफ डिफेंडेंट बाय पुटिंग सम इम्पोस्टर स्टॉप. द सूट वॉज कंटेस्टेड बाय द डिफेंडेंट बाय फाइलिंग रिटन स्टेटमेंट डिनाइंग द अफोर्सेड एलिगेशंस स्टॉप. द ट्रायल कोर्ट ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ द प्लीडिंग्स ऑफ द पार्टीज फ्रेम्ड नेसेसरी इशूज एंड डिसाइडेड इशूज नंबर 1 and 2 होल्डिंग दैट द सेल डीड वॉज ऑब्टेन्ड बाय द डिफेंडेंट दैट इज प्रीडिसेसर इन इंटरेस्ट ऑफ द प्रेजेंट अपेलांट्स बाय पुटिंग सम इम्पोस्टर इन प्लेस ऑफ प्लेंटिफ predecessor in interest of the present respondent by drawing adverse inference against the defendant who, despite the order passed by the court for production of the sale deed, had not filed the same in the court stop. Being aggrieved against the said judgment and order passed by the trial court, the appellants filed first appeal before the lower appellate court, wherein the court, after considering the facts and circumstances of the case as well as evidence on record, dismissed the appeal void judgment and order dated 27/10/2016 stop. Being aggrieved, the appellants have filed the instant second appeal stop. Para, learned counsel for the appellants submits that the trial court has grossly erred in allowing the suit for cancellation of sale deed and decreeing it in favor of the respondent plaintiff stop. The plaintiff had failed to discharge his burden of proof to establish that the alleged sale deed was executed by some impostor in favor of the original defendant stop. It was incumbent upon the plaintiff to have proved beyond doubt that the said sale deed was not executed by him, and the burden of proof in this regard could not have been transferred to the defendant stop. In this regard, he has relied on the judgment of this court in the case of particularly paragraphs 7 and 9 stop. He has also relied on the judgment of this court in another case stop para. It is submitted by learned counsel for the appellants that the allegations made by the plaintiff were required to be proved beyond doubt, as has been held by the apex court stop para. Submission is that the trial court has wrongly drawn the presumption against the appellant's defendants and has decreed the suit in favor of plaintiff stop. No such presumption could have been drawn by the trial court stop. In this regard, learned counsel for the appellants relies on the judgment of the apex court stop para. Learned counsel for appellants contends that the learned trial court could not have shifted the burden of proof on the appellant's defendants by issuing direction for production of original sale deed stop para. It is further held and submitted by learned counsel for the appellants that the first appellate court has failed to appreciate that the burden of proof was on the respondent plaintiff to prove the allegations in the suit, and it could not have been shifted on the appellant's defendant's stop para. It is contended that during pendency of the first appeal, the criminal case filed by the plaintiff under sections 419, 420 and 109 IPC that the sale deed was in question not executed by him but by some impostor in favor of original defendant was decided. As such, the application under Order 41, Rule 27, CPC was moved by the appellants to bring on record the judgment passed by the criminal court wherein the criminal court had acquitted the accused. However, the first appellate court committed gross illegality in rejecting the said application filed under Order 41, Rule 27, CPC. Stop.